Broadcasting from the world's largest film and television studios, this is KUSH from Universal Studios, Hollywood.
Enjoy food and drinks on the tram.
If you have anything in your hand, roll it on.
Ladies and gentlemen, in just a few moments, we'll be departing on the exciting tour of the Universal Backlot. The average length of the tour is around 1 hour, so we do recommend that you visit the restroom facilities prior to boarding the train. For your convenience, restrooms are located near the escalators by the tour entrance. Ask any team member and they can help you find your way. And enjoy the world-famous Universal Studio Tour.
Watch your step, watch your heads. If you guys hit your heads, please watch your language. Remember, this is a family park.
Welcome everybody to the World Cannon. I'm down to your right hand side, all the way down towards cars 3 and 4. STAs, please wrap and send. STAs, please wrap and send. All the way down to your right hand side, down towards cars 3 and 4, please.
Ya llegamos, ya llegaron Pablo, ¿eh? Bueno, mira. ¿Qué número nos tocó, Pablo? ¿Qué número, Pablo? ¿Siete? ¿Siete, eh? Hay que meterse en el carro 7. Espérate, ahorita que nos diga el señor. El 7. ¿Ya viste?
My name is Paul. I'm going to be your guide today as we lift the veil of secrecy on some of Hollywood's hottest filming locations. As they close these gates, watch your hands, arms, and legs. Make sure nothing gets caught in there. Young and very small children, we do say their feet can't touch the floor. They're sitting right at the edge of one of these rows. Now would be a good time to move them a little closer to the center for safety reasons. And if you did not pick up a pair of 3D glasses, raise your hands up high so we can get some to you before we take off. You're going to want those when the time comes. And once we start driving, it will be too late to get a pair of 3D glasses. So make sure one of our lovely studio tour ambassadors sees your hands up in the air before we hit the road. We're going to be taking off shortly. You're on board one of our, thanks Justin, one of our very first electric trams that we're incorporating into our fleet of vehicles. Here to tell you about our green initiative is Al Roker.
So, welcome aboard for an awesome experience that's also awesome for the environment.
That is right. We're going to be heading off in just a few moments. This is going to be the last call for 3D glasses. If you don't have a pair yet, put your hands up high and hit the road shortly. Good to go, so we're going to be taking off now. Turn to the left-hand side quickly before that tram pulls up. Wave goodbye to all these beautiful people waiting for their tour as we head away from the theme park and move deep into the heart of a real working studio where some of Hollywood's biggest names come to work every single day. Once again, my name is Paul, your guide on this beautiful Los Angeles afternoon. I am, however, not driving this vehicle. I am sitting backwards and being horrible like this. But we do have a driver. He just so happens to be the best in the biz. His name is Miller. Let's give it up for Miller! I love you, Miller. Thanks for coming. Yeah, we would be sitting on that road line for you, Paul. Love that co-host. We do have a few safety rules to go over real quick. First and foremost, if you have any emergencies of any kind, medical emergency, drop anything over the side of the tram, audio or visual problems, reach up, pull the red cord running down the center of the tram ceiling. I'll be back to assist just as soon as it's safe to do so. Remain seated for the entire tour. People will be inside the vehicle at all times. For whatever reason, this is the thing that guests find it most difficult to adhere to. Just stay seated the entire time. We've got to incorporate it into our tour more and more, so you're going to hear that about 5 more times throughout the tour. Stay seated, keep your hands on the inside of the vehicle. Going to be a lot of movement on this vehicle today. There's going to be some fire effects. Watch out for those. There's also going to be several water effects. Tons of great photo opportunities over the next hour or so. Keep an eye on those cameras to make sure they stay dry. There's still going to be time on this tour that includes vape pens. Finally, for your safety and those around you, no use of selfie sticks helping get in long before you get this vehicle. Alright, that does it for safety. So now head down our timeline. Put it up off to the right hand side. Fire station 51, first thing you're going to see on this tour. It's a real fire station. Those are not petrol cars. There's not a sand that we have filming. We function like our own little scenario. Sheriff's office, gas station, DMV, police office, restaurants, hospital wing. Really, the only thing we don't have that actually city has that is functioning is a population. We don't have a single person that actually lives here. But in the place of residential complexes, we have something that feels like it's not happening. We have Zach's first time standing, you can see on this tour, it's straight ahead of us. It'll be off the left side of the street. So I'll pull this down so you can come front lot. At one point, it was our largest mother truck. It just didn't make any sense ever to drive it on the right side. Sound stages here, four sound stages inside these two buildings. All four of them are where they filmed the show. 17 is where they filmed all seasons of Mr. Mayor. 18 behind the minions there is where they filmed the sitcom Coach, starring Frankie Nelson, as well as episodes of Good Girls, starring Baby and Mr. Mayor. And this last sound stage off to the right, 19 is where they filmed the Good Place, starring Ted Danson. A little later in the tour, this is where the X-Men are where they filmed that show as well. And off to the left, we've got another Ted. He is Cheers at You, it's an enormous beer, currently celebrating the release of his new series on Peacock.
Hi everyone, Seth McFarland here, and I'm excited to share with you a behind-the-scenes look at my Peacock original event series, Ted. It's a prequel series set in 1993. That means our skilled craftsmen can go to high school, house, and even recreate downtown Boston to look back in the day using the exterior sets and facades you're about to see on the tour. But I should warn you, Ted is intended for mature audiences only. So grown-ups, tell the kids to go in the other room before you watch. Oh, come on!
Off to the left, we're passing by four, offices. Mark Glass is off to the left. The Wicked Ball of Harmony is And the most famous office that we have, bundle 5195, just off to the left-hand side. A very famous profile on the side, belonging to the incomparable Sir Alfred Hitchcock. That was his office in New York. Sound stages, but we do have a couple more sound stages. is just off the left hand side before we go. These are the currently for the Lopez versus the Lopez. We're now entering into our back lot, where we film the big stuff. Exterior is shot on a very large scale. Gordon Street that you're seeing right down there. We'll loop around, I think we're gonna drive down here. Get up here. We're gonna loop around this big mural here and explore our metro sets a little more closely. New York Street is one of our most popular filming locations on the entire back lot. It's so much easier to come out here to our fake city. Remember the one we were looking at way up on the hill? We're going to drive through that now. So much easier to come out here and film than it is to go into the heart of a real city where you have to get filming permits, which are very expensive. You have to hire police officers to cordon off streets and reroute traffic. You have to deal with pedestrians walking by trying to see the actors that you're working with. You have to contend with all the sounds of a city. You don't have to deal with all of this when you're in our big city. And my co-host, Mr. Jimmy Fallon, is no stranger to filming in New York. That's going to be filming tonight. Shows by Jimmy Fallon, here he is to tell us a little more about what it's like filming in the Big Apple.
Hey everyone, welcome to New York. I got my start right here in New York on Saturday Night Live. This is actually my old neighborhood. What's that mugged over there? That old woman. Tough lady. That's my favorite hot dog guy. Hey buddy, how's it going? Remember me?
No.
Just like old times. Gotta love New York City. So it's not exactly New York, but a lot of times when you see New York in the movies, it was shot right here on the Universal Metro sets. If you can make it here, you can make it anywhere. Even if you make it here on the Universal Lot.
That is right. These metro sets have been used in a number of productions over the years. The street running parallel to us off the right, that's New York Street. It runs the length of our metro sets. One of our most regular productions filming out here is American Ninja Warrior. Once a season, they build their obstacle course all the way up and down New York Street. It's pretty incredible looking. Bel Air was just out here for about a week filming scenes from an episode on New York Street. New York Street doesn't only have to double as New York, despite what the name is. It has been New York countless times, like in episodes of Seinfeld, and How I Met Your Mother, and the Mindy Project. But it's also been Los Angeles, in Michael-based Transformers. It was Boston in Public Enemy. It's totally a different time period as well. It was the 1930s for Michael Mann film. It was even London in Austin Powers, The Spy Who Shagged Me. And it was the 1960s for that production in Chicago for the Blues Brothers. So we have a lot of versatility for how we can change these metropolitan sets around to look like any metropolitan area in the world at any time. We've collaborated with a lot of amazing filmmakers over the years. Photography or lights of any kind, and welcome to Skull Island. gentlemen, that was a good call. 360 is big game. The world's largest place of tax free experience. What I'm about to project now to the world's largest is something much faster, our picture cards. Off the left-hand side, you're going to see some of the most famous picture cards ever put on film. If you don't know what one of these vehicles is from, take a look at the sign behind the picture card. In fact, several of these vehicles have become just as famous as the people who are here. There, one from our Fast and Furious franchise. The newest addition is the Fry's Electronics Van from Jordan Peele's newest film. If you're a fan of that movie, we have some of the sets in the movie. Of course, we had several Jurassic Park vehicles back there as well. We're about to see a few more of those right now. We'll be up to the Jungle Island off the coast.
Welcome to Jurassic Park.
That is right, John Hammond. Take a look around and you see props and vehicles used in the Jurassic Park films. Off the left, the mobile lab unit from The Lost World. It's the same mobile lab unit that dangles precariously over the cliff's edge in a very exciting scene from that film. Oh my goodness. We've also got some empty dinosaur cages. I should probably warn you, some of our dinosaurs have gotten out and harassing some of our guests already. That mobile lab unit seems to be lost more or less than something about. Lights to simulate the lightning. Maybe we'll give you a full example right now. Miller, how we look. Well, the reason we're having to create our own weather, let's say it's actually raining, we're going to create our own rainstorm on top of that in the movie, as stupid as that sounds. Actual raindrops are oftentimes too small, too clear to pick up on camera. So we'll have raindrops that we can create with sprinklers, and we can control the size of the raindrops, make them about 5 times fatter than a real raindrop. That way we can actually see it on camera, and sometimes the water is still a little too see-through, so we'll have to add condensed milk or most often ink to the water mixture to make it a little more visible on camera. And sometimes we'll also backlight it as well. Miller, it's, I don't think it's working. It's, maybe move to a different position. Alright, let's just boogie. You're not going to see rain. That's... Okay, he's going to make a phone call. So I guess I'll continue telling you about fake rain. There's actually not much more I can say about weather effects. He's throwing my timing off. Hey, that scene you were just looking at from Jurassic World. Let's go back and talk about this. There's some cool stuff going on here as well as weather. There's a pretty cool stunt that happens in here, where Julianne Moore falls from the top of the mobile lab unit all the way down to the bottom. That's a pretty tough stunt to do for an actress who's insured for millions of dollars. But Steven Spielberg thought it was important to actually see her face in the shot so that you knew it wasn't a stunt person. So the way they actually did this stunt that I'm about to unpause is they started her down at the bottom of the mobile lab unit on the glass. She's wearing a harness that they didn't really take it out. They hoist her up into the air, and then they take that shot, they play it in reverse, and it looks like she's falling. Very effective little trick, is what it looks like. Great, here comes the weather effects. Lightning, thunder, and eventually rain. Maybe it's coming. We literally had someone else come up with their garage clicker and activate it for us. Alright, I'm starting to get annoyed. Sorry, folks. No, we're not going to get it. We're also throwing our flash. It makes sense. It's literally the oldest attraction that we have in the background. It's the first thing we get for the studio tour. Water rush is down. We're going to throw that flash. There's got to be something right there. This flash flood area is both the spot where the bike is about to drive through Old Mexico. We're both in the Lady Gaga's famous music video. They were also used in Three Amigos, and this is what it looks like on camera. Okay. The 6 points, this area is one of our oldest areas of the backlot, one of the most filmed on areas as well. In and around 6 points in the sound film area, they come to 200 restaurants a year that we still use these sets today. You know, once upon a time in Hollywood, football or TV sets. So if you throw some dirt down on the streets, get your actors in some period appropriate cowboy costumes, have yourself a pretty convincing little western town right here.
Now what say you mount up and get out of town while the getting's good?
Alright!
Well, I'll see you again, fella.
Well, you can count on it, fella. Now get.
This is the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
Well, we just have to talk it out, that's all.
All right, we're going to mosey on out of here as well. Now, folks, we're about halfway through the tour. Quick reminder, if you need to get my attention in the case of an emergency, use that cord running down the center of the tram ceiling. Otherwise, continue to remain seated. Keep your hands and feet inside the vehicle. We're going to exit out of these sets now. Straight ahead of us, we're going to see a peaceful little lagoon. They'll be off to the left once we loop around. Just beyond it, we got a few more sound stages. These are the sound stages I put out at the top of the hill to get into the tour. Pretty water is where we're from the voice. Now, peaceful to a good layer, but we're still Bellagio with it. That was not quite so peaceful back in the 1950s. That was the original Black Lagoon from Future Black Lagoon. Now, the Black Lagoon is far from the only monster movie that we've made here at Universal over the years. In fact, our monster movies are the movies that really put us on the map as a studio. Films like Frankenstein, Dracula, The Hunchback of Notre Dame, The Wolfman, The Mummy. Those are some of our biggest hits when we first started making films out here. And all of them filmed in an area called Little Europe, which we're going to be driving through next. Off to the right-hand side, as we enter this area, you're going to see a big sign that says, "Welcome to the Good Place." And this is also really from the exterior, so for that hit show, if you're a fan of The Good Place, take a look around, grab some photos. Not really, it's a good experience.
You are the show's fan.
Cool.
As I already mentioned, the central bus for this one is a small part classic Universal Monster Films. We didn't stop making monster movies after our heyday of monster films that we recorded movies. In fact, up until today, the continuing lesson center was that I am the central board of the film. Tall amongst all of them is maybe the greatest monster movie of all time. And right now we are heading back to Amity Island. You remember to remain seated and get up out of here. Now, I don't want you folks to worry because they've captured the shark that's been terrorizing the community. Strung up and stopped them right there. This day is not going to be close. My friend George, the police diver here, down there in the water somewhere. He was making sure they had the shark made their safety list. Oh my God. And George the 10 right for my friend George. George, you got to throw off the shark, get out of the water. George. Oh my goodness. Oh my God. Also, as we enter our wilderness area, we're passing by some animal crossing signs. My name is deer crossing signs. The duck crossing sign that you passed is a new one, though, to welcome in some of the newest members of our university family.
But Illumination, unfortunately, is a steward of a number of franchises.
Also where they discovered countless bodies in these procedural clothes. And off to the right-hand side, we have this big blue screen back there behind us. That is a large big digital backdrop where we can film any sort of background that we choose. And here is a practical set. We are right now heading into Jupiter's claim.
Work together to take an impossible mission and bring it to life. This is Jupiter's Claim, a nostalgic, small-time, Southern California amusement park owned by former child star freaking Jupiter. Over there, look into the waiting room and have your picture taken just like the kids in the old 1930s. Remember that one? A little further down, you can see the brand new Star Vassal
I'll stop another tool in the name is talking to everyone. We've been so long. stink pickle.
I am so tired of you stink guys stepping in. Just whatever you feel like.
Mute him.
Don't mute him.
That's better. We're moving your vehicle to a safe location until we have the situation under control. Until then,
my safety, I'm the one holding the gun.
Yeah, but mine's a whole lot bigger than yours.
Hobbs, escort this novice out.
Let's go, Cookie Puss.
You got an ugly suit on, man. It's cheap.
Somebody out there really pissed off shop. It's gonna get ugly fast.
Yeah, don't worry. Lucky for you, our whole family will protect you.
Are you kidding me, Roman? You didn't shut off your phone, bro?
I gotta call you back. I'm in the middle of something.
What I'm talking about?
Call you back.
Yeah.
It was on vibrate. Sean traced us. Ops can't hold him forever. Letty, Roman, we're up.
Driver, move that vehicle.
It's about to get real interesting. My Mona Lisa's all warmed up right next door.
Roman, grab your truck. I need you and Letty ready to roll.
All right, folks. That concludes the world famous Universal Studios tour. But it's not my problem. Hey, let's give one more big round of applause for our driver, Miller. Getting us around safely, nearly 400 acres of back lot. Don't forget, you can download the Universal Studios Hollywood app for up-to-the-minute park information, like park hours, wait times for your rides, and any other information you might be curious about. Find them on the app. Off the right, once you pass the screen fence, you can see a beautiful, lovely San Francisco Valley, pretty close to the San Francisco Valley. And that about does it for Stacy, but for the next few moments, until we pull in the tram unload and get those gates open, then head on back into the park and enjoy the rest of your day here. Because Hollywood is the entertainment capital of America. For me, find me off to the side of the tram as we unload. Otherwise, enjoy the rest of your day. Thanks for coming, everybody.
Rico.
Welcome everybody to the world famous studio tour. Thank you for joining us here today. Welcome, welcome. No need to chug your stardust. You can take our tour with me. Welcome to. Bye, folks. Enjoy the rest of your day. Have fun today. Remember us. Buy a bunch of merchandise. Bye, folks. Hi, folks. Welcome to the world famous studio tour. You made it. You're here. Welcome. Hello.
Thank you.